Well, good morning to you all on this, the second Sunday of Easter, traditionally known as Low Sunday. A warm welcome to those of you who are joining us from around the world. We particularly welcome a family in Ocean Springs, Mississippi, who for them this will be their vigil mass as they're about 15, 17 hours behind us. We welcome friends around the world to this service, and to assist you join in, I'm going to share with you where you may find some of our resources. If you visit the parish website, stgeorgeseastivanhoe.org, you'll be able to download the pew bulletin, which has the sentence, collect, reading and notices for the week. Also on the parish website, you may find our prayers for the week and also the organ postlude and hymn that Roger, our director of music, has recorded for us. All those items may also be found through links on our Facebook page, which is at St. George's East Ivanhoe. And for those of you who'd like to view the service in its entirety with the music added, you'll be able to find that on YouTube later this afternoon, Australian time, at our channel, St. George's Peace Memorial Church, East Ivanhoe. The order of service we use here at St. George's is from a prayer book for Australia, the second order, beginning on page 119. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercy, he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Christ is risen. Alleluia.
He is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, and that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, the strength of those who believe and the hope of those who doubt, may we who have not seen have faith and receive the fullness of Christ's blessing, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them. Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. You that are Israelites, listen to what I have to say. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with deeds of power, wonders and signs that God did through him among you, as you yourselves know, This man handed over to you according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of those outside the law. But God raised him up, having freed him from death, because it was impossible for him to be held in its power. For David says concerning him, I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand, so that I will not be shaken. Therefore my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. Moreover, my flesh will live in hope. For you will not abandon my soul to Hades, or let your Holy One experience corruption. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Fellow Israelites, I may say to you confidently of our ancestor David, that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Since he was a prophet, he knew that God had sworn with an oath to him, and that he would put one of his descendants on the throne. Foreseeing this, David spoke of the resurrection of the Messiah, saying, he was not abandoned to Hades, nor did his flesh experience corruption. This Jesus God raised up, and all of us are witnesses. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 16. Preserve me, O God, for in you have I taken refuge.
I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord, and all my good depends on you.
As for those who are held holy on the earth, the other gods in whom they delight,
though the idols are many that they run after, their offerings of blood I will not offer, nor take their name upon my lips.
The Lord is my appointed portion and my cup. You hold my lot in your hands.
The share that has fallen to me is in pleasant places, and a fair land is my possession.
I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel. At night also he has instructed my heart.
I have set the Lord always before me. He is at my right hand, and I shall not fall.
Therefore my heart is glad and my spirit rejoices. My flesh also shall rest secure.
For you will not give me over to the power of death, nor suffer your faithful one to see the pit.
You will show me the path of life. In your presence is the fullness of joy, and from your right hand flow delights forevermore. A reading from the first letter of Peter. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to the exiles of the dispersion in Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia, who have been chosen and destined by God the Father and sanctified by the Spirit to be obedient to Jesus Christ and to be sprinkled with his blood. May grace and peace be yours in abundance. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. By his great mercies he has given us a new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who are being protected by the power of God through faith for a salvation ready to be revealed in the last time. In this you rejoice, even if now for a little while you have had to suffer various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith being more precious than gold, that though perishable is tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honour when Jesus Christ is revealed. Although you have not seen him, you love him. And even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy, for you are receiving the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Concerning this salvation, the prophets who prophesied of the grace that was to be yours made careful search and inquiring about the person or time that the Spirit of Christ within them indicated, when it testified in advance to the sufferings destined for Christ and the subsequent glory. It was revealed to them that they were serving not themselves but you, in regard to the things that have now been announced to you through those who brought you good news by the Holy Spirit sent from heaven, things into which angels long to look. Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. You believe in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are they who have not seen me, but who still believe. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. And if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May the words of my lips and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and redeemer. Amen. On Easter Day, I talked about the world as a grand stage, a grand theatre, and how we're called to be signs and agents of that new resurrection life. 1 week later, in this great story, how have we become signs and agents of this new life? In the story today, we hear how this new creation, this new world order that Jesus brought into the world has been passed to his followers. Some take it up with energy and enthusiasm, others doubt. But all are called to be those signs and agents of change, to bring joy and hope to all whom they encounter. In a perverse way, they are called to infect their population, the people around them, with the joy of this resurrection life. They stand and stood as a counterpoint to the ways of their times. We, in our time, stand as a counterpoint to the ways of domination in our world. So which will we be? Will we be like Thomas, who apparently doubted, who looked for physical signs of the presence of God in his life? Do we need to see and touch? Or do we believe because the evidence has been laid before us in these historical narratives, but also in the living of our lives? When we encounter people like ourselves, touched by the waters of baptism, who in the living of their lives bring light, life, peace, and hope. Now more than ever in the history of the world, we are called to be people of peace and hope. So wherever you may be in the world and whatever your circumstances, let us think today how we might bring peace and hope to family, friends, and neighbours. We often believe that we are powerless, but we are probably more powerful than we ever know. Through the medium of the internet, we are able to reach around the world. So let us reach out this day and bring reassurance to those around us, and share with them the joys of this story, this most wonderful Easter story, which is given to us. Amen. Let us together affirm the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
us pray for the world and for the church.
In the power of the Spirit, let us pray for grace to do the works of faith. Gracious God, grant to the church, the gathered people of the gospel, wisdom to know and power to proclaim the good news of the resurrection. Hear our prayers this day as we pray for the Church Universal, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Philip, Archbishop of Melbourne, for the Right Reverend Dr. Geoffrey Driver, Archbishop of Adelaide and Primate of the Anglican Church of Australia, and for Genevieve, our Bishop. Make your church and her ministers strong in the name of Christ. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, we pray for a world where many wish to believe but are held back by doubt, particularly in the face of pandemic. Open the way to freedom that is in Christ, that his peace may prevail among the nations and in the hearts of all people. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, bless our prayer and partner in mission, Sorted Youth Church in Bradford, England, as they seek to build relationships with young people and empower them to help form new Christian communities. May their participants find friendship and an opportunity to explore their faith. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, grant to us, our families, friends and neighbours, the grace of the resurrection. Break through the closed doors of our fear and doubt, and give us the faith that needs no sign, but the knowledge of divine love present among us. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, have mercy on all who suffer persecution for their faith, who must meet in secret and cannot worship openly. Give them strength in their need, light to those who oppress them, so that all who trust in the resurrection may be free to share their joy. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, bless those who bring aid to the infirm in our community. May they be an example for others to follow in the paths of mercy, as we seek your healing presence for all who are afflicted by the virus. And in our own community, we bring before you Alan Tracy, Mary Jones, and Merv Pizzi. Heal each according to their need. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, we pray for the departed who trusted their Lord in this world and now see him in the fullness of his glory, as we remember those who have died in recent days, particularly those who have died as a consequence of the pandemic and those who have died alone and afraid. May their sins be forgiven, and may we who now follow in faith share with them the promised blessing, as we remember with love and affection those whose anniversary of death occurs at this time. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Lord, in your mercy. Pray in the name of Christ, by whose wound we are healed. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers. Grant that what we have asked in faith, we may by your grace receive. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." Let us pray. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord.
trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same, Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Christ, our Passover Lamb, has been offered for us. Therefore we come to celebrate the festival. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith with a sincere and a true heart. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins. Strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We are the body of Christ.
His Spirit is with us.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offerings for your glory and for the service of your kingdom.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. He is the true Paschal Lamb who was offered for us and has taken away the sin of the world. And now we give you thanks that you raised him in triumph from the dead. And by his death he has destroyed death, and by his rising to life again has restored us to eternal life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we
proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine. And we pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup and again, giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. Shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. His mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen. Our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us your peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Let us pray. Eternal God, giver of life, in the breaking of the bread we know the risen Lord. May we who celebrate this holy feast walk in his risen light and bring you life to all creation. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Good morning to you all once more, and welcome to this online streaming service of Holy Communion from St. George Peace Memorial Church here in East Ivanhoe, Melbourne. Particularly warm welcome to those who have joined us around the world and to those who will watch this recording later in the day. I draw your attention to the notices in the pew bulletin, which you may find online at the parish website and on Facebook. Particularly grateful to those who exercised a ministry of presence by calling different people in our community over the last week to 10 days. That has been very much appreciated as we seek to stay connected with one another and also have the opportunity to broaden and deepen our knowledge of one another and so deepen our relationships. I'm pleased to report that all in the parish are well and generally remaining connected and in good spirits in this time of pandemic. I thank all those different people who've sent materials, prayers, articles, reflections and photographs for our Facebook page. Continue to do so and I'll share them with the parish and broader community. In the week ahead, I will convene the first meeting by Zoom of our planning for our end of COVID-19 party, and that will involve people both within this worshipping community, our hall users, and the broader community of East Ivanhoe and beyond. We'll continue to work with the technology. At the moment we're using an iPhone with a microphone on a tripod, and we know there's some challenges with light and sound, but we'll continue to work through that. We have an opportunity to rent some equipment from a company that might enable us to raise the standard of broadcast, but that will require some donations. So we look forward to seeing you in the week ahead, either on telephone, Zoom, FaceTime, WhatsApp, and to join us again next week at 10 o'clock for this service of Holy Communion. God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working you what is pleasing in his Son. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia. In the name of Christ. Amen. Alleluia.